So this is another trade. This is not the cabling going on for IT. This is for low voltage lighting. It's kind of interesting that people are going to that these days. And then some of these blue cables, not the whole pack, but the drop down, that one drop down, that's going to be for the lighting. It looks like they're using the same Cat 6 cable, maybe something different. I'll take a look at it. All this heavy cable is for the IT support. Telephones, computer networks, stuff like that. And those little white cable hangers are called stiffies. They've been out for years. It's just another way to hang cables up in the ceiling. See if I can get a good shot of them. So this is going to be the main distribution frame here, and as you can see, all the feed cables coming here, and you always pull from the center. So here's some of their boxes. Now they're just about done this job, so they have about 30 more cables to pull out of about 80-100 cables that have already been pulled. So we're just about finishing up, and this is called pre-cable, so this is not unusual. This is what it looks like. I do not know what the white cable is. It looks like possibly speaker cable. But the blue cable is Cat 6. You see all the boxes here. They're just getting started today. So they kind of consolidated their boxes last time they were here yesterday. And they're just setting it up for... you haven't yet set it up for the runs that they're going to be making. So you see some more over here, some more of their equipment, toolbox, things like that, tool bag. So you always pull from your MDF or IDF out, not the other way around. I've seen people do it the other way around, but man, that's just a pain. And there's a way to do it this way. You know, what's really nice at this point is, I don't know if you can catch it, that light by, I think it's Milwaukee. It kind of lights up the room. Yeah, it's a Milwaukee product. It's an LED, obviously, and got a big battery pack down there. You can charge up your drill and things like that for a work site. It has a nice handle. It's kind of light, but it's heavy enough that it's not going to fall over. It's a good deal, and it's a shop, not a shop light, a job light, so it's really nice to have. Of course, in Southern California, might nice to have during a blackout, a brownout, as they call them sometimes. They're saving energy. So you can see there's a cable path here. It's the main path. And you keep on seeing these cables, this one cable's in the ceiling. And I asked the trades, what is that? And that's for lighting. They're going to go with low voltage lighting. And I imagine that's what lighting fixtures are here, are low voltage. But it has nothing to do with IT. And but you can still see the feed. It's a nice size job. Nice size job. I think one of my biggest jobs I ever did was downtown LA at 800 feeds, 800 pulls. And with 800 pulls and you punch them all down, it kind of gets difficult to identify each pull and it takes a long time. So that's where I came up with the idea of the cable identifier, not tester, cable identifier. It's still dark out. I mean, it's really dark in this room, too. I gather those things are speakers. Not too sure. Has nothing to do with the IT company putting in cables today. But notice that what they did is they took an extra stringer. You had a couple extra stringers up there. They're called stringers, the things that hold up the grid, stuff like this. This is the perfect time to run. Actually, it'd be better even if the grid wasn't up yet. But this is a good time to pull. It's not hard. It's a little more difficult if you didn't have the grid up. It'd be a lot nicer. But you got those stringers up there. That's the metal rods coming down from the ceiling. They come down. I don't know if you can see it because it's kind of dark up there, but there's a couple stringers that the people who put in the grid, or maybe the installation company put it there also. But it's you can use those. So this, let me see if I can get it there. There you go. This cable management device is attached to a stringer that's holding the cable in place. Pretty normal setup for a job site. You see a lot of trash, things like that. A lot of other trades working, and you stay out of their way. They stay out of your way. If your cable's in the way, sometimes trades will just. I've had it only once or twice in 30 years, but they will actually cut the cable. We need more light here. This is kind of a dark site. But this is the path to the last drops. Now, that's how you count them. It's by drops or pulls. You can call them pulls, but pull cable. And I always did it in three ways.
Pull more down or
yeah, but let me get through this hole.
That's it.
That's all you got? Okay.
Now that's something we always do. We always pull string with our cable. It just makes it easier.
Oh yeah.
And you know, I've talked to some people who they pull from each location to the MDF.
I don't understand that because you're moving all your boxes around.
Yeah, you're moving all your boxes around.
And they're not light, you know. They're 40 pounds.
Yeah. Now, I notice on some of the boxes you write probably footage, right? Footage used?
Yep.
Or somebody's doing that.
Yep, that's me.
That's you? Why you do that?
So that way I know how long the pole is. If I get shorter box, like I got a couple of like 140s,
mm-hmm.
I know when I can burn those in one pole.
Mm-hmm. So I noticed you don't... Not that I did. I never labeled them anymore. That takes forever.
Oh, the cables?
Yeah.
Yeah, and only certain customers require it, and then mm-hmm. we tell them, it, well, it's a lot of extra work, so it's extra money.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I've also seen where they want things done in order, each jack.
Sequential.
And it's like, no, that takes about 30% more labor.
No.
At least 30% more labor to put them all in order like that. And it's for nothing, you know. It's,
it doesn't matter in the end.
So how do you identify the cables?
So at the end, we have the data lights that we got from you guys.
Oh.
We'll plug a tester in on that side. It'll light up the patch panel, and then mm-hmm. we'll test it and label it.
So a cable ID system, right?
Yeah.
People say, well, you know, I've sold lots of these, and people will say, well, where does it test the cable? I said, it doesn't test the cable at all. Yeah. It just identifies the cable.
Yeah.
Now you need to test it.
Yeah. Now it saves a lot of time from toning every port the old way.
Oh, yes. And you would not believe some of the pushback I get on that. That I don't know what I'm doing. And it's like, you know, I've been doing this for 30 years, man.
Yeah.
And I came up with that when I was doing an 800 drop on a building in downtown Los Angeles. And it's like, you know, you have all these patch panels and you're looking for numbers on it? No.
Yeah.
No.
It definitely is a time saver.
Yes. Definitely saves time. So here's a little commercial. Was it worth it, buying them?
Absolutely.
I know you bought a lot of LEDs lately.
Pull down some more?
No, I think we got enough.